Hello, and welcome to Just Have Another Think, our twice-monthly look at the ecological, environmental, and social consequences of the 21st century climate emergency. One of the areas of the world where all three of those impacts are being felt as much, if not more, than anywhere else, is in the countries of Sub-Saharan Africa. And one of the double whammies currently being endured there, especially in many of the rural off-grid regions, is the impact that a lack of electricity is having on local air pollution and the educational opportunities for young people through the simple lack of something that we take completely for granted in our comfortable Western homes, the reliable supply of light at the flick of a switch. For kids in those regions, kerosene lamps are the only option for them if they want to study after sunset, and those lamps are absolutely catastrophic for health. And of course they contribute to CO2 emissions too. So I was hugely encouraged to discover a UK company who are working to address this problem with an elegantly simple solution. And having spoken at length with their school's programme manager, Francesca Shirley, I thought it might be nice to let her tell you all about their work directly. So, here's Francesca's film.
Why are there still almost a billion people in the world who don't have access to electricity? Why do some countries have the latest smartphones, devices, and technology, while others still use kerosene lamps and diesel generators for light and power? To answer these questions, we need to look back at how things got this way. It all started with the Industrial Revolution, which created even greater income inequality between the global north and the global south. The steam engine powered factories and freight, facilitating mass production, and that created more jobs and higher incomes, lifting millions of people out of absolute poverty. It also lowered the price of commodities like electric lamps, which hugely improved people's lives in industrialized nations. Very few of those resources were accessible to people in the global south, so the inequality continued to worsen. Today, that global inequality and income gap is more like a chasm. Countries with the highest incomes are more than 100 times richer than the poorest. The widespread lack of modern technologies and infrastructure means hundreds of millions of people still live without access to a centralized, distributed electricity grid. As a result, they don't have power at the flick of a switch at home that we take for granted. So they're left with no other option other than to use dangerous, outdated fossil-fueled appliances for their heat and light. Some use candles or homemade kerosene lamps made from an old food tin or jar. Kerosene, which is basically an aviation fuel, is poured into the vessel and then a piece of material or rope is immersed to soak up the fuel to make a wick, which can be set on fire, providing an open flame for light in the evening. It's a very inefficient combustion process that not only contributes to atmospheric warming through its CO2 emissions, but also contains about 7-9% of black carbon, which is toxic to human health, causing severe lung and eye disease. For comparison, burning a piece of wood produces only about 0.5% black carbon. Arguably, the most harmful impact of these lamps is on young people who have to use them to do their homework. The light level is so low, kids have to work right next to them to get any benefit from the dull flickering flame, which means it's inevitable they'll be directly inhaling toxic black carbon particulates. Teachers say they can tell when their students have been doing their homework before they even get to class because they can hear them coughing. And when they do arrive, their eyes are bloodshot and irritated. And then there's the risk of house fires and severe or even fatal burns. The lamps are easily knocked over, spilling their flammable contents and setting people's homes, businesses, and livelihoods ablaze. Kerosene-related fires and injuries kill more people in Africa every year than malaria. The price of kerosene in Africa varies depending upon location. It costs around 96 cents a litre at an urban pump and around $1.30 per litre in rural village shops. So the annual running cost for a kerosene lamp equates to about $50 if you live in an urban location and about $68 if you live in rural areas. By contrast, an LED bulb can run for an entire year at a cost of around $3. Many people who use kerosene for light are living below the international extreme poverty line on less than $1.25 a day. That means the poorest people in the world are paying the highest cost per unit for the worst possible quality of lighting imaginable. Young people who study hard and have a desire to reach higher levels of education are putting themselves at serious risk of ill health and worsening the future impacts of climate change on their community. Research shows that a student studying for a few hours a night with a kerosene lamp inhales a similar level of pollutants to someone smoking 40 cigarettes. Globally, air pollution prematurely kills between 7 and 8 million people a year. That's more than malaria, HIV, and COVID combined. We already have all the technology we need to overcome this crisis, raise living standards, and vastly improve people's quality of life. The challenge is inspiring the masses to join together and work on the solutions. Our solar LED light contributes towards tackling the root causes of inequality and rising global emissions by giving people access to safe nighttime illumination for studying, working, traveling, or just relaxing. It minimizes the risk of premature death from exposure to excessive air pollution and fires, while also displacing 92 kilograms of CO2 every single year over its lifetime. Specifically designed to be efficient, high quality, durable, and affordable, our solar light won the 2016 European Product Sustainability Design Award and is one of the Solar Impulse Foundation's 1,000 Solutions to Climate Change. Action against our humanitarian climate and extinction crises doesn't always have to be in the form of colossal, grand sweeping gestures. It's the little things that can add up to make a big difference. Through Namene Solar's International Schools Programme, we're working with teachers in schools in the Global North who share our passion about solar energy and global goals education. Our aim is to connect students across the inequality chasm and bridge this divide by providing cross-curricular links between STEM subjects, humanities, the arts, and the global goals. Students get to build a solar light from a kit of parts that becomes their very own to keep for their own adventures. The Assembly Challenge is a fun and engaging way to highlight barriers to education in parts of the world that have suffered the most from global inequality. It shows our kids the power of small, simple solutions, and it provides a tangible link between students north and south of the equator. Plus, for every light a student builds, Namene will send another one to their peers in Sub-Saharan Africa. I'm very lucky to have been working with an exceptional green committee made up of incredibly motivated students in London for over a year. We're also so proud to be partnered with the phenomenal Million Solar Stars organisation. I've had the honour of working alongside Adam Hall testing cross-curricular activities with his Solar Stars group in Dubai. Together, we're working to inspire 1 million students to help us get solar energy and education to 100% of schools globally. Sunlight is the most abundant form of energy we have. The living world is essentially solar powered, and nowhere receives as much of it as the mid-latitude tropical regions where Namene is focusing our efforts. Our solar LED light changes lives the moment it reaches the hands of an off-grid family. It eliminates the cost of kerosene fuel, improves health, and gives an instant source of safe renewable light. The ability to study in the evenings is transformational to the educational opportunities for young people without access to grid electricity in sub-Saharan Africa. In every part of the world where women's education and gender equality have been improved over the last century, fertility rates have dropped dramatically as women have gained greater autonomy in their choice of when to start a family and how many children to have. We're so excited about our schools program because education is the most powerful tool we can use to steer change and mitigate our energy and resource waste, enable and empower our purchasing to move in a direction that leads to a brighter future for everybody. Education for women and girls and family planning across the whole globe is our top solution for achieving the drawdown of CO2 from our atmosphere, which is crucial to us achieving the targets set out in the Paris Agreement. This year, we're launching our brand new solar light with a buy one, give one campaign to help get the power of solar to as many people as possible. For every solar light purchased, Namene will donate another to a child living without electricity access in sub-Saharan Africa. We can't wait to share this, and if you'd like to hear more, you can sign up to get an early bird discount on your own solar light at www.ockersolarlight.com. And if you are a lean green solar education machine and you'd like to build your own solar light and get involved in our schools program and activities, or find out more about our international schools program, you can drop us an email anytime at schools@namenesolar.com. And you can always stay connected and see what we're up to on Instagram, LinkedIn, and Twitter. Search @namenesolar and look out for our logo. Thank you so much for watching.